What's going on, guys? In this video, we're going to talk about how to make all over Sublimation t-shirts just like this one right here. Let's begin. All right, guys, I don't know if you know this, but every month retro Jordans are released in different colorways and people sell shirts to match these sneakers. There's a huge market for this and people are making a ton of money. One of the best things to sell is all over sublimated t-shirts like this one right here. In this video, I will show you how to start an all over Sublimation t-shirt business. Check this out, guys. This is a store on Etsy and the person running the store is selling these Sublimation shirts. In the past 2 years, he sold over 13,500 units. He's selling these shirts for $30 to $40 and the shirts cost him around $5 to make. On Etsy alone, he makes over $110,000 a year in pure profit. That's not counting his website, eBay, and other platforms. Now, I'm not trying to knock anyone's hustle, but this guy's being very bold and he's putting Nike and Jordan logos all over his shirts, as well as copyrighted pictures and trademarks of NBA team logos. Now, you guys can't be doing that. In order to do that, you have to get an NBA license and they will want around 12% from each sale. Let me show you guys how to get an NBA license. We're going to type in NBA license into Google, click on the first link, we're going to scroll down, and right here, you're going to click right here and download the application. Now again, guys, what this seller is doing is none of my business, but you can't use Nike and Air Jordan logos, even if you have an NBA license. That's trademark infringement. So even if you guys can get away with that, I don't recommend you do that. It's better to just start a long-term business without the headaches. You guys can easily go around copyrights. I'll make a video on that soon. Alright guys, let's talk about the equipment you will need to buy to make these shirts and also how sublimation works. Sublimation printing is when you use a special sublimation ink and heat press it on a polyester fabric. When the ink is pressed onto the fabric, it can never be washed off. It becomes one with the fabric. The first thing you guys will need is a large format sublimation printer. The best one is the Epson F6370 and this is industry standard. This printer costs a little bit over $6,000. Now don't let that discourage you guys. If you're a go-getter and not one of those people who's scared to start a business, it's almost impossible not to make money if you have this printer. There's also a ton of things you guys can do with this printer besides making t-shirts. What I recommend is you guys don't buy the printer outright and to finance it for around $300 a month. You guys can also put it on a credit card that has a zero interest fee for a year and put it on that. It's always better to finance equipment instead of buying it outright. If you guys don't have credit, go to Capital One or Discover and get a secured credit card and pay it off for about 8 months. That should be enough to build some history. Now, the next thing you guys will need is a large format heat press. This will also cost you around $7,000. Again, you guys can also finance this for around $300 a month. Basically, you'll be paying off the equipment with the sales you're going to be getting, and at the end, you will have a free asset. You will also need sublimation paper rolls and sublimation ink. Aftermarket ink is very cheap, so your prints will cost you almost nothing. You can get wholesale inks on Alibaba by the gallon. The next thing you guys will need is to buy wholesale blank shirts, such as the American Apparel sublimated shirt, or you guys can get blackout sublimation shirts. Now, these are basically sublimation t-shirts that have black sleeves and a black back. As you guys know, sublimation can only be printed on white fabric, and a lot of you guys ask me how to make black sublimation t-shirts, and this is a great way to do that. Also, in my opinion, these shirts are more prestige. Both of these types of t-shirts will cost you around $5 wholesale, and if you guys start selling a lot, you can source sublimation t-shirts for even less. The way sublimation printing works is you print your design on the sublimation paper using the large format Epson printer. You then put a blank shirt on top of the heat press and put the printed paper over it. You heat press the design on the blank shirt and then remove the paper. The ink becomes one with the polyester shirt. You can do this either on one side or do both sides. Keep in mind, when you guys print on blank sublimation shirts, there will be little white marks for areas that couldn't be printed on, and that's fine. This is very common with all over sublimate shirts. The way to prevent these is to make sure you flatten out the t-shirt prior to pressing as much as possible. The thing is, even large brands who sell sublimated t-shirts will still have some of these white marks. The only way to prevent this is to print the sleeves separately and have them sewn onto the t-shirt. Alright, check this out, guys. So what I did was purchase one of these shirts from the seller, and honestly, guys, it's embarrassing. Again, I'm not trying to knock anyone's hustle, but I'm sure if one of my subscribers made one of these shirts, they'll be much, much better. Look at this shirt, guys. This shirt has defects everywhere. First of all, look at how pixelated the picture is. How can you sell a shirt and have pixelated graphics? It's not hard to Google and find high resolution pictures. Look at the flaws from the Photoshop design. Nothing was erased correctly. Look at Jordan's lips and nose. They're red. I mean, come on, if you're gonna sell a shirt, just take the time to make the file right one time. I was gonna give the shirt away to someone because I don't wear stuff like this, but I can't even do that because it's embarrassing. Honestly, if you guys are gonna have a t-shirt business, just take pride in your work. What this seller doesn't understand is that he's losing a ton of money in the long run by half-assing these shirts. Whenever this seller gets a sale, he gets the customer's email address, which is free marketing. If you have a good product and the customer is happy with their purchase, anytime you come up with a new product, you can simply send out mass emails to your customers, and that's free marketing. But if you sell garbage, that seller will never buy from you again, so you're losing a ton of money. This seller doesn't understand that you'll always make more money on the back end than the front end. Also, one more thing I want to add is this seller is getting his shirts from Mexico, so they're not the highest quality. If you're going to be selling shirts for this price point, you should be using high quality t-shirts. Also, to make the shirt high quality, you should be using your own custom Plastisol tags, which costs around 10 cents to buy wholesale. You can easily get custom Plastisol tags on Etsy. And also, if you guys notice, when he pressed the t-shirt, all of the sublimation ink is all over the neck area, area and the tag. That's unacceptable. Anyway, this seller is selling about 50 shirts a day on Etsy alone. The men's size costs around $40. This shirt costs around $5 to $6 to make, so he's making around $25 to $30 clean after all fees and shipping. So this seller is making over $1,000 a day just selling these Jordan shirts on Etsy. Alright guys, let's talk about some of the different ways you can start a sublimation shirt business. The first way is making shirts just like this seller right here. You guys can sell different shirts of athletes, celebrities, movies, and more. Just watch out for copyrights. You guys can design your own t-shirts, or you can get somebody to design it for you if you don't know how. If you want someone to design your t-shirt, you're going to go on a website called Fiverr.com. Here you'll be able to find a bunch of t-shirt designers. They will charge you around $5 to $10 per design. The only thing is make sure you guys try several designers, because not all of them are very good at what they do. You guys can sell these shirts on Etsy, your own website, eBay, and more. Let's take a look at eBay real quick. Alright guys, so we're going to type in custom sublimation shirt. And here you'll see a bunch of t-shirts. So let's check this one out right here. So you see this Jordan Pippen shirt. The seller sold 29 of them for $34. He sold 6 of these right here. He sold 8 of these shirts right here. And if he can sell a shirt with cereal on it, I'm confident you guys can make designs that sell. And by the way, he has over 5,000 feedbacks with 98% positive feedback. All right, guys, another way to start a business like this is to make custom designs for people using pictures that they send you. So a customer will simply email you the pictures they want, and you make the shirt and send it to them. It's that simple. You guys can also make a website like this, similar to Printful.com. Another way to start a sublimation t-shirt business is to sell wholesale either to clients online or to clients locally. So say, for example, you own a sublimation printer and someone else wants to start selling sublimated t-shirts. Say, for example, it costs you $5 to make a shirt and they're gonna buy wholesale from you for $10 a piece. But the thing is, there's gonna be a minimum order quantity of, let's say, 20 pieces. So each order is going to make you at least $100. Now you can do this either online and then have it sent to them, or you can sell locally. You can advertise your store on Google and print everything at home. Let me show you an example here. We're going to type in sublimation printing into Google, and right here you guys will see different local stores that make sublimation shirts. Alright guys, obviously there's many ways to do this. These are just a couple of examples. Also, if you guys buy a printer like this, you're not limited to just making sublimation t-shirts. You can make many things such as hats, socks, hoodies, sublimation jackets, and much more. Now, one more thing I want to talk to you guys about is that I know a lot of you guys have online businesses where you order items from China and then resell on eBay, Shopify, or Amazon. That's great, but as you guys know, sometimes there are delays in manufacturing or shipping, and that can stop cash flow temporarily. The great thing about owning a machine like this or a DTG printer is that you don't have to rely on anyone. You can make a product in a few minutes and sell the same day. So overall, this is a great asset to own. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please hit the like button. It really helps out the channel. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.